Well, let's see. I'm still like.
You're like this over
here.
Him.
Well, he just stabbed me and he's smiling at me, so I'm gonna turn the blade this way and just try and
to
kill
cut
him.
His head off.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm so into that. That's so great.
We're learning a lot about Magnus.
I'm not sexually into it.
13 under my. That's an extreme, because that's under my 13.
Yeah.
All right, so you got an extreme.
Yes.
Extreme!
Decapitation!
So
extreme decapitation!
Is it decapitating him here?
It's just like, yeah, it's kind of,
wherever
goes up here.
Your throat.
It's giving him rear ears.
Oh! No, 16.
No, he still doesn't do it, but it's close.
That was a good roll, though. Good try,
guy.
That's
a good roll. So.
Roll damage?
Yeah.
That is 8.
So you bring the blade up and it gets like caught right here on the jaw. You're doing damage and like you see blood coming out and he tries to stab you again.
What an idiot.
He's not quite dead yet.
Jeez. Really? Jeez.
Only a flesh wound.
Well, you did 7 non-lethal damage to him.
No, I'm trying to kill him now.
Yeah, but before you did like 7 non-lethal damage to him.
The skein creatures, it's ongoing.
Okay.
So. The Skiing Vikings were definitely, BSB Care made that comment a while ago. So that was part of it. Ben turning into a bear was part of it. And I'm not done with a few other things that are gonna happen.
Holy crap.
It was just gonna be a straight battle, but what they did was bring out all the magic stuff. All right, those, you guys will never be able to read those
either. They brought a Gandalf.
Thanks for bringing Gandalf.
A Gandalf.
The Gandalf.
The Gandalf.
And Gandalf?
All right,
I never say your Gandalf.
Oh, come on.
A Gandalf.
Boop.
Mumble it again.
Either way.
I'll do it. Either way.
No.
It was either a 6 or a 4.
Yeah.
It was either a 6 or a 4.
I was just kidding. Oh,
okay.
You made it totally legitimate. Okay.
Almost won.
So, yeah, stabs you in the side again. See how much damage he does this time.
I'm like...
1, 1, 1, 1.
6!
Oh, no.
Somehow got a 9.
Stabs you hard again. You're gonna die! I'll kill you before you kill me.
It's a knife.
He'll speak my name and not yours.
Ooh.
No. Yes, 6.
So he's pressing the knife and you're pressing into him. What do you want to do?
I mean,
just try to push harder.
Yeah, harder.
Pretty much.
Give me a strength roll, but with a disadvantage, because you've taken so much.
Yeah. Don't roll over a 90, Megan.
20.
No, it's
50. Sorry, 59 under my 90.
Okay. So.
You
start pushing, and it like catches up, and you like start separating. And it gets hooked up underneath right here, underneath his jaw, and you click it up and go past his jaw kind of pops this way.
Yeah,
kind of
like.
And his,
demonstrate on me.
You know, you feel like a pop when you pop his tongue out, and it like, and then you barrel down and you cut through the top of his mouth into his brain.
A lot of description.
And then he starts to like just shake because his nervous system is going all fucking wonky. And then he just stops.
I feel like something with teeth has to have happened right there.
Yeah, you definitely see teeth. And you just kind of,
I would just push harder. Teeth!
Right then, because he was able to distract you, the Gandalf was able to cast another spell.
What a jerk.
And this huge...
Oh, Gandalfs.
Nobody even likes a Gandalf.
This huge, vortex opens up over the city.
What?
And all of these fireballs start flying down all around.
Put them out
with the snow. And start just smashing into things. Now, you're on the ground.
It turned into D&D.
Like, you're on the ground.
Hell, yeah.
And you're seeing up into this vortex, and it's a different realm above you.
Okay.
It's coming from a different place.
Okay.
And you're realizing at that moment that something, we're just ignoring. We're ignoring and we're moving on.
I got him.
You got him, you did. Can you do a sand check for me? Because you're seeing all of these creatures trying to escape the void.
I'll do a sand check. I made it.
Okay, so you take 1 point anyway.
Good.
Just that's it. All right, so you realize right then that these fireballs are hitting everywhere, and these creatures are gonna be coming out of this vortex at any moment.
What?
So you have one of your options is to try to get the people and get them out of one of the side places to get them away from the city, but the city's burning.
Okay.
It's going down.
Yeah, we've got to get out of
here.
We
got to flee.
We can't win this. They've got fireball portals to other places. I'll just start. I imagine the door is barricaded from the inside, but I'll just start pounding and say, everyone, it's Grimur. We have to get out. They're taking the city. We have to flee.
All right.
Don't look up. Just flee.
You hear them, and you see your father not far away.
They open a portal to
Muspelheim.
Yep, exactly. You see your father not far away, and he's fighting all of these things, all of these creatures, as you're trying to get, and you suddenly get that flash you got from, before the battle that said, that you would have to push your dad out of the way. And the guy who was chasing you around is coming up behind him and about to strike. So you now know that to save him, you're going to have to jump in and hit him out of the way.
Okay. I do that. I know better than to mistrust my glimpses of what might be. So
okay. You don't need to make a roll because it's been foretold.
Okay.
It has been foretold. You knock him out of the way as the sword comes down and you save his life and you guys both stumble out and you fall on the ground next to your father. And your father leaps up quickly. He's very spry. And
he drinks all that blood.
He swings straight at the guy who's been following you around and just cuts him in half, right? And he says, son, get the people, run to the gate. I'll keep everybody off you as long as I can. Go now, go!
I have a brief, small, dramatic moment where I realize he's called me son for the first time ever in my life. Mm-hmm. And then
achievement unlocked.
Single tear.
All right, so you run off and you start getting people out.
Yeah.
Fireballs are hitting all around the place, right? So
I feel like I'm boarding a plane with that noise.
Because the passengers we are currently
Grimir has finally achieved his father's love.
You're underwater, and you're feeling a lot better.
Sure.
You just got smacked, and that's perfectly fine. Mm-hmm. You see this creature coming for you. You're still kind of playing dead. It's up to you what you want to do. Do you want to lure him out, or do you want to jump out and run towards him, or how do you want to
do it? How far away is he?
He's not far. He's like maybe 15 feet.
I'd like to hold action.
Okay.
Until he's like right on top.
All right, so you wait, and then right when he's there, he gets right up next to you. What do you do?
I super slow motion, like, action. He just...
Come right up out of the water.
Am I a bear?
You stabilized your bear human.
So like I have like claws.
Yeah, you have claws.
Yeah, I'd like to uppercut swipe like just like as if I'm scooping his guts out of his.
Out of his, okay. So give me a roll.
I believe that's called an upperclaw.
Upperclaw?
Upperclaw.
That's a 21.
Woo! He's a high bear form.
So you hit?
Yeah.
Okay. Because you surprise him, I'm not going to do a defense roll. Give me your damage.
Is it
2d6?
2d6.
Nice!
That's good damage. That's how you roll 2d6.
Yeah!
So you shove your hand and like just right up like a melon ball.
You know what I'm gonna be doing.
Yeah, right? Go ahead, tell it.
Yeah, no.
Go for it.
Yeah, so I'm scooping, like it's just like streaming, like I'm assuming it's kind of a putty skin creature.
Yes,
it's all coming away. I get underneath his rib cage and pluck out its heart like it's an apple from a tree.
Oh no.
and I shove it in the face.
I hope he's like a bunch of different wares. Like he's a bear, a fish.
Sometimes he's tentacle wear.
We'll never know.
We'll never know what you're gonna get.
But I take a big bite.
Okay.
And I spit in his face.
All right.
As he's falling over. And then I eat the rest of it.
And he falls down into the water, splash. And that's when you notice that
the other bigger guy.
The guy that's twice as big.
The frost giant.
It's Thor.
That's coming out of the water.
It's Thor. Thor is there.
Not cool, man.
I eat Thor's heart.
That was
now you're
my
a thunderwear.
What?
I said he's a thunderwear.
He's a thunderwear.
As you're coming.
Werestorm.
Thunderwear. That should be that should be something. All right, so.
Everything's on fire.
Everything has now burst into flames.
Okay? What?
People are scattering, including the enemy, and you're in the water. You guys are on the side of this all. You don't know what's happening with the people in the town, the innocent people in the town square or in the town hall. But there are these huge explosions going on, and then this vortex. You guys kind of look up, and you see this big vortex, and these creatures are trying to claw their way into your reality. So I need sand checks. You can't see this because you're on the mountain.
Yeah, I'm fine.
You take 1 point.
Mm-hmm. Huh? Okay.
Well, I'm trying to.
50, I'm fine.
You're fine, you take 1 point.
Okay.
So you've got all these people.
I'm down to 72.
I'm down to 49?
As you're getting to the edge of the of the fence, and you're getting people out. You turn around and you're kind of up on a hill, and you can see the hall and the where your father was fighting. And he's fighting like three people, and one of them comes right up behind him and just gets him right in the back. And then you see him get chopped down, just blood going everywhere. He falls down, and one of them just lops his head off.
Does that make you the Jarl?
No,
I don't think that's
illegitimate.
Yeah. So they cut his head off. And you're looking around and you see all of this horrible carnage, just people burning, people running away. But you got all the innocent people out of the hall. I need you to make a sand check because you just saw your dad die.
Papa! Instead of in the French way, huh?
Okay, so you just take 1 point.
When I get upset, French words come out. I did say mayor.
You did say that.
Your thrall turns to you and goes, "Sir, we've got to go."
Enfroy.
Of course, I was here. Thralls aren't allowed to fight.
I'm at 73, dumb sanity.
Hit points.
We can't.
He's a fifth level fighter.
we can't leave. We have to give our men the proper burial.
We'll bury them later. But we've lost.
Okay, help me make sure that we get all of the children in the
yes,
infirm.
We're doing that right now. Let's go. We have to keep moving. We'll come back. So you guys go.
Yeah.
Okay. So you like it's like fun. You're like, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. And you realize that you don't see where the creatures are anymore, but you realize that the Gandalf
every time he says this, it makes me so happy.
Pulling down the vortex is open. He's doing something, right? Mm-hmm. Make an intelligence roll.
Okay.
Kill him.
41 under my 50.
Okay. So you start to realize what's going on. You make the connection between what he's doing and the horrible events that are happening. Mm-hmm. You must strike him down as quickly as possible before the creatures get through the vortex.
Where are the other monster-y things?
You can't see them.
I can't see them?
No.
But I can see the Gandalf.
You can see the Gandalf because you were high enough up.
I want to essentially try to sneak back towards him. I assume he's facing the town.
Yeah, he's facing the town. He's like a conductor doing a big orchestra.
I basically want to, I want to see if I can sneak
shut the fuck
down
up.
Behind him. Can I see Leaf or the red tunic guy? Okay. So yeah, I want to try and sneak over there, see if, how close I can get without him seeing me.
Okay.
And then whenever I have a chance, I want to try.
Give me a sneak roll.
Okay.
Shonk him.
Yeah. Shonk. Ooh. Shonk him.
Shonk him.
Shonk him.
Here's my spell. 49 under my 50.
So, wow.
Yes.
You done stealth.
I did.
You done stealth there. All right. So, yeah, you're up.
Okay.
You get up behind him. When you get up behind him, you notice that his arms are, like, really kind of gross long. They're just, like, kind of, they're a little longer than they should be. And
this makes no sense.
He's got, like, this weird, like, scaly-like skin, it almost looks like a serpentine skin, almost. And he's doing these big motions, and his hands are kind of encased in this glowing fire, like a greenish fire, as he's, you know, saying these words. Mm. And just his presence makes you uncomfortable and just kind of fearful of him, even with his back turned. You're almost afraid of him looking at you. Mm. So give me a sand check.
I don't know. Sand is currently...
It's the lie. She actually really rocks at sand.
I made it. That's 78. Is my
wow.
sand.
Oh, wow.
75 under my 78.
Okay, cool. So you make it. You still take a point.
Okay. So I have 77 now. Boom.
So you can attack.
What I want to do is pull my sword back and try and cut off his head.
Okay. Very Conan of you.
Thank you.
All right. So.
The librarian.
That's what you do to Gandalf.
It's the best way to do it. Yeah,
everyone knows it.
It is. Yep. Absolutely.
Right?
It'll still attack.
Yeah.
But you can just walk away.
That is a 19, nice. So wow. That is a hard success, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's 15. Okay.
So, give me your damage.
You know what? I want to roll a different damage die. These are annoying me.
No, the girls you came with.
No, I don't like those right now.
The girls you came with.
All is right.
Solid
this
choice.
One time I'll accept
11.
That.
11. So you hit and cut into his neck.
Uh huh.
And you go about three quarters of the way through.
Long sword!
And he takes his hand and he moves the Uh-oh. Sword back and turns towards you. And his Uh-oh. Head is just like this, like kind of off a little bit.
Cool, and it falls the rest of the way?
Mm-hmm. I say it overbounces the terror.
It's like anime, white light comes.
And he starts to reach with one of his glowing hands towards your throat.
Shield.
He's got his eyes are actually mouths.
Oh, good. That's normal. They're all
then,
teeth, right?
And then he's got teeth. He's got a mouth that's like the regular. He's got a serpent mouth, and he's kind of coming towards you like this.
Teeth
I need
days.
You to make another sand check.
No, not that.
Because of your phobia?
Damn it! Wait, that is my sanity.
Oh! Is it your old sanity?
It's
or
my
your,
current sanity.
So you made it then.
Yay!
So you still take 1 point.
Well, okay, I have 76 now.
Okay, cool. All right, so...
You can't take down Birna.
He's reaching for you, he's gonna try to grab your throat.
Can I try? Oh, I
yeah,
guess
you
I
can.
Have... I mean, I could... I don't know. There's a lot of actions, I suppose.
He's got your blade with one of his hands.
Right.
So you can either let go and jump back, or you can let him grab you, and you can push through and try to cut the rest of his head off.
Mm, he's got a lot of teeth, right?
He does.
Yeah, I'll probably try that. Yeah. I'm like seeing all the teeth, right? I'm like, oh God, teeth!
This guy has way too many teeth.
Okay.
All of what the
am I
teeth.
What am I rolling? Dodge?
You're rolling... Are you're dodging?
Well, no, I want to.
You want to try to cut through him. So roll an attack roll.
Okay.
You're going to let him touch you?
No, I really don't want to, but the teeth are freaking me out.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah.
67 under my 75.
Freaky teeth.
Okay. So,
Yes!
And he falls down, his head rolls over, and the portal starts to close. And it starts to... It starts this huge, you know, like wind starts whipping around.
Putting out the fires?
The creatures that were down get pulled back up into it.
Yes.
Okay. And it shuts. But entire village, the entire town is completely decimated. It's just flames.
Wah, wah.
And you guys have lost a lot of people. So,
what about the skiing Vikings?
They were the ones that broke through and started burning up everything.
Are they still around though? Like, but did they?
No, they all scattered once.
They scattered once. Okay.
Yeah.
So I want to organize, you know, a bucket brigade and try and save whatever we can.
Okay. So you guys spend the rest of the night trying to save. When you come down.
I find Leaf and the red shirt guy, right?
Okay, the red shirt guy's dead.
Well,
that's what happens when you
seen it coming.
Wear a red tunic. I mean,
the red tunic.
You find Leaf. He's been wounded, and when you look at it, you realize he's been stabbed. He has not been bitten. Mm. So one of the creatures did not find him, meaning Repscap got him. He must have attacked him first.
Well, I want to help him back to the town.
Fuckwad gives you 5 points back.
Yay, to my health.
Yes, and yay, I'm supposed to let you know that your Twitter has Twitter has links for you.
Okay.
Cool.
We'll check it out. Okay, thank you. So fine.
We'll have to share that with
us
next
time.
I will.
Know about that.
I have 11 now, hit points down.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, well, I was trying to be helpful.
Jeez.
Ooh, dumb.
Little attitude back there.
You should put your shirt back on, man. You're getting testy back there.
A little testy.
You've had too much freedom time.
Freedom. Freedom.
See? Puns. Puns are Jordan's.
It wasn't on purpose.
It was good, though. Jordan. Who was the one that was like, I can't say puns here because I get in trouble or whatever?
Yeah, because I was on Never Tell Me the Odds and I got a bonus die for doing a pun. I was like, what?
Nice.
You guys are so nice.
Oh,
everyone
man,
just makes
I
fun
be
of us
show.
On Black Bag.
Black Bag.
It's a good pun show. Yeah.
So you guys you guys spend the rest of the night trying to put out fires and...
Am I still a bear?
No, you
stop back.
Because do I have to I don't have to Did I know I was a bear?
No.
Cool.
That was part of the that was part of the special thing that they got.
But now you have tentacle arms, so.
Yeah.
Basically, what the event was.
I mean, I'm naked again.
Well, what the event was originally they were going to just attack from the sea. But BSB Care during the week said it would be great if they skied into and attacked. That was his, and he posted a picture. I'm like, But then I was like, well, that'd be a cool thing to offer. So I put the snake magic user dude up
the Gandalf.
The Gandalf.
The Gandalf. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I put the Gandalf up on the side.
Mm-hmm. Would it help if we called him the Mithrander?
No. No, it wouldn't. So, and then the fish people, because originally there was just going to be a few fish people, but then they became all fish people. Mm-hmm. Basically, it made the entire battle
epic,
a lot bigger.
And thank you, Burgermeister, Meister Burger, and BSBK.
Yes.
Yeah. So you mean to say that anyone watching the show can donate in order to make wicked cool crap like that happen?
Wow.
Every week.
So I changed my plus to being a werebear.
I honestly thought the battle was only going to last maybe 45 minutes, and then we would get into after the battle stuff, whatever that was going to be, because I had no clue. But
we had some pretty epic battle happen there.
We literally battled
almost 3 hours.
But hopefully Chad enjoyed
That's more than all of the combat we've done on every episode of Black Bag together.
Yeah. That is true, yes.
So, here's what you guys see. Oh. Sad Viking music over, because I don't have any queued up, but sad Viking music. And a decimated town with lots of your fellow Vikings dead or severely injured. And you're walking through the carnage. Your dad's been stricken down. You got all the children and the elderly out before they were hit by a fireball. But now you know, and I think everybody make an intelligence check for me.
I nailed it.
A 2 under my 50.
Holy crap.
Stuff like this happens in the epics all the time.
Tuesday.
I missed it by a lot.
Okay.
I got it.
All right. So you guys are looking around and you're realizing that with the Jarl dead, with a good portion of the other able-bodied Vikings, both male and female, down. There is nothing for you guys to do but, you know, get whoever you can together, because everything's been burned down. It's raiding season, so you guys are
going to fight to them.
You're going to have to go and raid a village or something to recoup some of the loss that you've got. You've got to get money somehow. Or, you know, goods. And you're kind of walking through the muck and the mud and everything else. And suddenly, someone grabs the back of your hair, pulls you back, and stabs you in the back. And Gora says in your ear, she goes, she can't grab you in the back. She has to just stab you. So she just stabs you because she has one hand.
One arm.
I forgot. So she just stabs you, and she says, I sent him to kill you, but obviously you're much harder to kill than I thought. So let's see how much damage you take. Oh, only 1 point, because she's got one hand.
You still suck.
Now I have 10.
She's like, God damn it.
Yeah, well.
I can't aim as well as I used to aim. What do you want to do?
Well, at this point, she didn't do a whole lot.
She didn't.
So.
She still stabbed you,
guys. I'm just going, let's see. Is she behind me still?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm just going to turn around with an elbow right to her jaw.
Okay.
Right in the teeth.
Yeah, so is.
This is just,
in the
Viking.
Jaw. In the jaw. The mouth is closed.
Oh, that's
it's
right.
In the jaw.
Yes, so that's a 22 under my 70.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, so you that hit hurts. Her. And she spits out all of her teeth.
Oh!
It's actually worse like that. Than that is kind of worse. Knife wound.
Yeah, that was a hard success. Okay.
Yeah. Do damage.
Okay. Where's my unarmed? 1d3.
So just roll a d6 and half it.
Ah.
Plus and another d6, because that's your damage bonus.
Yes. So this one is the one I was, well.
Yeah.
Okay.
So 5. Right?
Yeah, min one, I guess. So
four,
yeah.
Four and a half.
Four and a half or five damage.
Four and a half.
So you crack her good. She, are you doing, you're doing non-lethal, right? Or are you trying to, like, kill her?
No, I'm not trying to kill her. I mean, she did just stab me, even though it was kind of, I was kind of like, good one.
Right.
It's Viking right. foreplay.
Viking foreplay. So you knock her teeth out. And she like
Vikings with you.
She like stumbles a little bit, and you realize right at that point that you're not so afraid of teeth anymore. You kind of passed it after cutting through that guy's head.
Which is good because you just got showered with them.
You just got showered, and you're
immersion therapy.
It's all good.
Yeah.
So she stumbles back, and she starts just bawling. Like, I don't have my arm anymore, and I can't believe it. I just wanted you
but
to
die. But she's just around with one hand, though, right?
Yes, just whatever.
You kind of keep walking into this. I'm just saying.
You did it on purpose, though. You shoved him forward.
Well, really, if you were as good as you claim to be, you would have gotten out of the way.
Dad, you're just a horrible person. Just fucking horrible. You mountain.
She starts walking away.
Oh. Whoa. Parting shot.
And I'm just like, eh. And go the other direction.
Okay.
Lumbers the other direction.
She's a huge
avalanches the other direction.
Slowly, so she's glaciering.
Okay.
That's true. That's true. So, you guys, what plans, what, how do you want to set up for, like, what are your plan? Just talk briefly about what your plans for the town are, how you're going to, because you have, you've got a couple of boats that you can man to go out. You know England is there.
So who's the next Jarl?
You guys don't have anybody running the show right now.
Basically.
Everybody. Well, one of the elders could take over.
I think someone's going to have to put themselves forward.
I mean, I would.
Well, know, what is.
She's 17.
No, what is Michelle's character's name?
Ingveld?
Ingveld. She slept through this fight.
Right, but
no, she fought.
Yeah, she was fighting. She's the Jarl's sister, right?
No.
No.
Okay.
Magnus' sister.
Right, right. No one is, I'm not even related to the Jarl.
But.
Okay. His other son was
weren't
murdered.
Men still more likely to be in.
Yes.
Yeah.
But we're not being completely historically accurate, so it's possible.
We're probably going to have to do like an elder council type thing.
Yeah.
I mean, I would say for.
I will take it.
Okay.
You need to go on a boat.
I will take this responsibility.
I would later. Say we probably want to like start setting up tents for shelter, start trying to rebuild the wall so okay. that we are, you know, protect somewhat them. Secure.
Right.
And then our raiders probably want to start organizing to resupply. Right. So like while the rest of us stay and kind of try and like rudimentary rebuilding.
Yeah, we'd want to set people up into like, you know, you do this thing, you build homes, you whatever.
So do I have architecture? I do not. So yeah, I don't know.
All right, so
I'll build a wall.
Thank you guys. So we're gonna stop here.
Okay. Makes Avenger great again.
Hashtag. You know, we almost made it through a whole game with that.
Sorry.
Mentioning
Massa.
So thank you guys all very much. I hope you enjoyed the battle that was much bigger than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
Thank you for unlocking all of the events.
That was really cool.
We now have a werebear.
And there's such a thing as a Gandalf now, and that's all you guys.
There's a Gandalf.
It's you!
And she got to cut its head off.
I did, it was great.
It was awesome.
With my trusty sword.
You also killed off T-Rex's...
Sifatrex.
Sifatrex!
Nice try, buddy, but I'm real good at hiding on roofs, so...
What is going on this weekend? We have masks, and I believe we have...
Venus Dawn
Command, both tomorrow. Mask starts at 12... 30. I believe 12:30, and then Phoenix is at 5.
Five.
So we've got two great shows tomorrow. Please check them out. The next week we have Monday Night Dungeon Fight.
Monday Night Pillow Fight.
But before that,
oh yeah, okay.
There's couples therapy
where we'll be doing nothing special for Valentine's.
Is it going to be Valentine's Day?
Nope. Not unless they do something in Diablo 3 for it.
I didn't really even realize it was Valentine's Day.
It's actually not. It's the next day. Oh no, Tuesday. You're right. Yep. So go ahead.
Yep. Oh, and then Tuesday. We have, let's see, it starts with
Disorganized Play
with Tom Lommel.
And the return of Whitechummer.
Yeah.
Whitechummer
Shadowrun.
Yeah,
and I believe show. Henry has been hard at work on the map for the next one.
Map.
So.
Excellent.
And then
you have a 6-year-old making the map?
I don't.
Tyler does.
Tyler does.
Yeah.
That's his show.
How many dinosaurs are in this?
All of them?
probably all of them in the next one. It was just a boring old house last time.
Boo.
And then on Wednesday we have Misadventures, which is our Harry Potter Pathfinder homebrew show that I'm in. It's fun. Watch it. And then Thursday.
Great set design.
Yes,
she does
by
a
Talene.
Lot of stuff.
It's great. And then Thursday we've got more Disorganized Play with Tom Lommel, and I believe Garav will have time for games.
We can't ever know for sure.
Usually does. And then next Friday is Never Tell Me the Odds, our Star Wars Fantasy Flights game.
And we could keep going from there
we
in
can.
Kind of an
Forever,
endless circle, but we won't.
Ever.
Because we have a lot of shows.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, 2 Mondays from now is the next episode of Dinner and Dragons.
That's true. That is true.
Coming up is next weekend is Strategicon.
Yep.
Oh, and yeah. I believe we're both going to be there with Mason. And who else is Stephen Pope is going
to
be there.
And I believe we have some other Saving Throw regulars are going to be there as well. I believe Tracy is. Are you two?
We're not. We're seeing Cher. Okay. We're seeing Cher that weekend.
Okay. Fair enough.
As you do.
But if I could turn back time and... okay, anyways. Okay, we get it.
I had your puns, I swear.
But I would encourage you, if you are in the LA area or could be in the LA area in 2 weekends from now, we definitely would love to see you there and meet you. I don't know if we have the graphic up with some pictures in case you are somehow just listening to this and not watching us and don't know what we look like, but please come and say hi. We'd love to hang out with you.
Cool. And you're running a black bag game?
I'm running black bag games. I'm running 2 games of black bag, and I'm running 2 games of Rothane. Mm-hmm. So Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I've got 2 games on Saturday, and then one-on-one on Friday and Sunday.
So if you come to Strategicon, to OrcCon, too could kill a Gandalf.
maybe.
It could happen.
The black bag game, though, in the same universe, is not going to be a Viking game.
But there could still be a Gandalf.
There could still be Gandalf.
We can't say 100%
probably
that there won't be.
Because you're pushing it, they're going to be a Gandalf. I'm going to be forced to have a Gandalf.
For all we know, wizards could be called Gandalfs in Realms of Rothane as well.
Yeah, why not? Let's just shove this down Wes's throat as many times as we can. Put the Gandalf everywhere. It's like the Google.
Sure.
You know?
Yeah,
good. That's good. So on a personal note, I'm Blight Mail Games is doing Numenera right now. We have unlocked... I haven't done the newest one. We've unlocked 96 tracks so far. We're going to 120. Wow. We still have about 19 days, but if you jump in now, the more people we get, the closer we get to the really, you know, to the big 120, and then some other stuff that's going to be going on. It finishes on the 28th. If you like what I do, you can use it for Numenera, but you can also use it for other fantasy stuff. I highly recommend taking a look and checking it out because we always appreciate it.
And you hear it here, guys. It's really awesome, and yeah. I can vouch for it. I've used it in some of my home games. It really ups the feel and the tension at the table. It's awesome stuff. Check it out.
Absolutely.
It's a lot of fun. So check that out. That's what's going on with us, and I've got...
Wes, if I can clarify, what you're saying is you've hit your goal, you're already
We're doing stretch goals.
So if you jump in, you're automatically going to have access to those stretch goals.
And the stretch goals are only $500 apart, so they're not, it's not like, oh God, I gotta wait until they hit $2,000 or something. Every time we get like 9 people, a new stretch goal opens.
Fantastic.
So definitely check it out. And plus, if you haven't gotten anything from the past and you wanna check out old stuff, the add-on packs through the Kickstarter are cheaper than the drive-through RPG stuff right now. So it's like 50 cents a track. So definitely go look at it. I will be at, the con in a week. So if you're there, please come by and say hello. And follow Plate Mill Games on Twitter. And anything going on with you guys besides couples therapy?
No, I don't think so. But make sure we also have Patreon, so you can check that out for Saving Throw. Okay. And you can follow and subscribe if you want to here on our channel.
Woo!
Yeah.
Cool. Anything with you guys going on?
Well, some
Loot Crate.
Some Loot Crate goodness.
Woohoo!
What?
Be sure to go to lootcrate.com/savingthrow. And
coupon code Saving Throw.
Coupon code Saving Throw. We are doing currently gaming. Loot Gaming is our February crate is wild. In that crate, we're promoting the new Legend of Zelda game.
Ooh.
We are Legend of Zelda. Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Pitfall. It's an amazing Pitfall item. I can't tell you what it is. No.
He just opened the box.
And a World of Warcraft item as well.
Ooh.
And also, just check us out, because I made a GIF that's real fun. But also,
is it in the box?
It is a box. Oh. Also, next Wednesday, There's going to be a big announcement. So you should check out lootcrate.com/savingthrow on Wednesday, because we have something new and awesome happening.
And that's advanced news, guys.
It really is. Cool. It really is. Very we usually cool. don't
you
like.
You heard it here first.
Yeah, we don't do usually promote things that are coming, because usually we just let it happen. But I'm going to tell you, you should check it out, especially if you like video games.
Ooh.
So yeah. Also, if you buy the Wild Crate, we have for our Epic Drop this month, 3 Nintendo Switches and 3 copies of the new Legend of Zelda game. So everyone who buys a Loot Gaming in February is automatically entered in.
There you go.
Wow.
I don't know if that'll work.
Would that work?
This is like money, right?
Right, this is money, correct. Yeah, it says 1,000 on it.
Mine says 5,000.
bidding war.
10,000!
You got anything, Nick?
No!
I have nothing else to plug, except that I will see you on Tuesday for Hoy Chummers, and we will learn what happens to the worst Shadowrun team in Seattle.
Thank you guys so much for watching Black Bag. We really appreciate it. We had a lot of fun. We hope you had fun, and we will see you in a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Bye!
Bye!